After studying this module, you shall be able to know how are exchange rates determined, identify the factors that influence the demand and supply of currency, understand international arbitrage and interest rate parity, evaluate and analyze the interrelationship between various parity conditions. Exchange rates can be classified as fixed and floating according to the degree by which exchange rates are controlled by the government. Exchange rates are important for government and business organizations to facilitate international trade and payments. Any change in exchange rates in either direction influences the cash flows, and exchange rates are influenced and determined by product prices and interest rates. Exchange rates, whether spot and forward, product prices and interest rates have equilibrium relationships, also known as parity relationships. Also, parity relationships are influenced by arbitrage. Exchange rate determination. Exchange rate equilibrium. The exchange rate is the price of one country's currency in terms of another country's currency and is determined by demand and supply forces in the foreign exchange market. So, any change in the exchange rate is a result of a change in the supply of and demand for foreign currency in a country. The point of intersection of the demand and supply curves gives the equilibrium exchange rate. Let's look at the demand for a currency. A country's currency is in demand when foreigners buy the goods and services exported by that country, or when they want to buy financial instruments denominated in that currency. For example, the demand for US dollar is derived from demand for US goods and services in other countries. Any increase in the US dollar value will be caused by an increase in the price of goods and services of US denominated currency. This results in a reduced demand for US denominated goods and services. The reverse will happen when the foreign currency US dollar value decreases. Suppose the exchange rate of Indian rupee against the US dollar is at Indian rupee 62.50. If the exchange rate appreciate to US dollar by Indian rupee to 45, the price of US commodities in terms of INR decreases. As a result, the demand for US commodity increases in India, leading to rise in demand for US dollars. The reverse will happen if the exchange rate decreases. Thus, demand for a currency in the foreign exchange market increases with the depreciation of that currency. Let's look at the supply of a currency. Supply of a currency derives from the demand for imported commodities denominated in foreign currency. When the country's imports are priced in a foreign currency, the resident buyers will sell their domestic currency for the foreign currency to pay for imported commodities, which contributes to supply of currency in the foreign exchange market. For example, the supply of the US dollar as against the Indian rupee depends upon the demand for Indian commodities in the United States. If the exchange between US dollar and Indian rupee decreases, the cost of Indian commodities will also decrease. As a result, the demand for Indian commodities in the United States increases, leading to the increase in the supply of US dollars in India. Thus, supply for a currency in the foreign exchange market increases with the appreciation of that currency. Equilibrium. The equilibrium exchange rate is the exchange rate at which the demand for a currency is equivalent to the supply of the same currency. Factors affecting the exchange rates. There are several factors that affect the exchange rates through their effect on foreign currency demand and supply, leading to the new equilibrium exchange rate. The factors that influence exchange rates are: 1. Inflation rates. Inflation is the result of expansion of money supply in excess of real output growth in the country. Inflation influences exchange rates by affecting the competitiveness of the country's commodities in the foreign markets. Because of inflation, the country's goods would become costlier and the exports will decline, leading to a decline in the supply of foreign currency. Also, exchange rates are affected when the inflation rates are different in different countries. A higher rate of inflation in India relative to the rate of inflation in US will increase US exports to India and reduce Indian exports to US. Secondly, economic growth rate. High economic growth rate of the country leads to the more economic transactions within the country and across countries. This will cause the equilibrium exchange rate to the new equilibrium rate. Thirdly, political factors. Political factors do influence the demand for and supply of foreign currency. Political stability in a country may attract a large amount of investment funding in foreign currencies as investors find the country to be less risky and more rewarding. Thus, increasing the supply of foreign currency. On the other hand, political instability of a country may drive away investors from the country. Thus, the demand for foreign currency will increase. Fourthly, social factors. Social factors like education levels, communal and regional harmony, and demographic characteristics affect the demand for and supply of foreign currency in the country. For example, high literacy and education levels may increase cross-border movement of people and cross-border flow of funds. Fifthly, government controls. Sometimes government puts strict controls and barriers on imports and exports. All such controls influence the demand and supply of currencies in the foreign exchange market. Government or the central bank of the country may also directly intervene in the foreign exchange market and influence exchange rates. Therefore, exchange rates are highly susceptible to government controls, barriers, and interventions. Arbitrage, interest rate, and exchange rate. Movement of funds from one country to another is a common phenomenon in order to maximize the wealth of the investors. Investors borrow in markets where interest rates are low and then exchange the currency to invest in the markets where interest rates are higher. This situation gives them an opportunity for arbitrage. The term arbitrage refers to an act of buying currency in one market at lower prices and selling it in another country at higher prices. Thus, difference in these exchange rates in the two markets provide an opportunity to earn profit without risk. Arbitrage or international arbitrage can be of three types. One, locational arbitrage. Locational arbitrage is the process of buying a currency at the location where it is cheap and immediately selling it at another location where it is priced higher. Locational arbitrage is also known as simple arbitrage. For example, at two foreign exchange centers, the following Indian rupee and US dollar rates are quoted. For example, in London, between rupees 62.5730 and 62.6100. In Tokyo, between rupees 62.6350 and 62.6675. The arbitrage possibilities for an arbitrager who has 100 million rupees may be found by the following modus operandi. One, he will purchase US dollars from the London foreign exchange market at the rate of rupees 62.6100, as it is cheaper as compared to Tokyo foreign exchange market, which is rupees 62.6350. He will obtain US dollar 1,597,188.95 on conversion at the rate of rupees 100 million by 62.6100. Secondly, he will sell US dollar 1,597,188.95 at the rate of rupees 62.6350 per US dollar and will obtain 100,039,999.90. Third, as a result of arbitrage, he will earn a profit of rupees 39,909.90 without any risk. Locational arbitrage is normally conducted by banks or other foreign exchange dealers who can continuously monitor the quotes provided by the banks. Locational arbitrage applies not only to the banks on the same street or within the same city, but to all banks across the world. Triangular arbitrage. Triangular arbitrage is also known as three-point arbitrage, as there are three currencies involving three markets. For example, the following are three quotes in three foreign exchange markets. Dollar 1 is equal to rupees 63.51 in Mumbai. Pound 1 is equal to rupees 99.68 in London. And pound 1 is equal to dollar 1.62 in New York. Assuming that there are no transaction costs and the arbitrager has 1 million US dollars, then arbitrage gains are possible since the cross rate between US dollar to British pound by using the rates at London and at Mumbai is different. That is rupees 99.68 to rupees 63.51 is equal to US dollar 1.5965 to British pound. From that of New York, that is dollar 1.62. The arbitrager can adopt the following steps to realize arbitrage gain. 1. The arbitrager will buy Indian rupees with US $1 million. The total proceeds he obtains is 63.51 rupees into dollar 1 million, which is equal to rupees 63,510,000 rupees. 2. He converts Indian rupees in British pound at the London foreign exchange market, where he receives 63,510,000 rupees to rupees 99.68 pounds, which is equal to 637,138.844 pounds. 3. He then converts 637,138.84 pounds at the New York foreign exchange market. He then obtains 637,138.84 pounds into dollar 1.62, which is equal to US 1,032,164.93 dollars. 4. Thus he has net gain of 1,032,164.93 dollars. 5. Dollar 1 million is equal to US 32,164.93 dollars. Covered interest arbitrage. Borrowing in one currency and lending in another, or investing in securities denominated in another currency with the currency risk covered or hedged in the foreign market is known as covered interest arbitrage. For example, assume that an investor borrowed 10 million US dollar in the United States for 1 year at an interest rate of 6% per annum. He converted 10 million US dollars into British pounds at an exchange rate of British pound to US dollars of 1.75 and received British pound 5.72 million. He then invested British pound 5.72 million in the British pound denominated bank deposit for 1 year at an interest rate of 8%. Simultaneously, he entered in the forward account to sell the maturity value of the bank deposit, that is British pound 5.72 plus 8% of 5.72, which is equal to British pound 6.18, in exchange for the US dollar amount at the forward rate of British pound by US dollar 1.80. After 1 year, the investor received US dollar 11.124, that is British pound 6.18 multiplied by 1.80. Repaid the loan with the interest, that is US dollars 10.60. Thus, he finally made a profit of US dollar of 0.524 million. It is to be noted that the investor has converted the US dollar amount into the British pound at the spot exchange rate and invested that amount in the British pound denominated deposit. Simultaneously, he has sold the British pound forward at the 1 year forward exchange rate. All these operations take place at the time of investment. So, any change in the exchange rate during the investment period does not affect the investor. This type of a portfolio is known as an arbitrage portfolio, which is completely self-financed. 2 points should be noted in the above example. First, the investor did not commit his own funds anytime. Second, the net cash flow on the date of maturity is known with certainty. Interest rate parity. Interest rate parity describes the relationship between forward rates and interest rates. Once market forces cause interest rates and exchange rates to adjust such that covered interest arbitrage is no longer feasible, there is an equilibrium state referred to as interest rate parity or IRP. In equilibrium, the forward rate differs from the spot rate by a sufficient amount to offset the interest rate differential between two currencies. The basic principle is that there is an interconnection between the interest rates and the exchange rates. The IRP theory states that premium or discount of one currency in relation to the other should reflect the interest rate differentials between the two countries. In other words, the interest rate parity theory states that the difference in the interest rates, that is risk-free, on two currencies should be equal to the difference between the forward exchange rate and the spot exchange rate if there are to be no arbitrage opportunities. IRP can be summarized by saying that where the interest rate differ from one country to the other, the spot and forward rates will not be the same. The spread between the spot rate and forward rate is influenced by the interest rate differential between the two currencies. Thus, interest rate parity can be represented by the following equation. That is 1 plus KH divided by 1 plus KF is equal to FT by SO. The same can also be written as KH minus KF is equal to within brackets FT minus SO divided by SO. This means that the interest rate differential is approximately equal to the forward rate differential. Such a relationship is called an uncovered interest parity relationship. If the interest rate in India is 8% per annum and 6% per annum in Singapore, the uncovered interest parity relationship would imply that Singapore dollar is expected to appreciate against the Indian INR, that is the Indian rupee, by about 2%. Let's take an example. The interest rate in India and the United States are 8% per annum and 6% per annum respectively. The current spot rate is US dollar to Indian rupee 62.4354. If the interest rate parity holds, what is the 3-month forward rate? Solution would be the 3-month forward rate will be F90 is equal to 62.4354 within bracket 1 plus 0.08 divided by 4 bracket closed divided by 1 plus 0.06 divided by 4 bracket close, which is equal to 64.6394. The US dollar has a 3-month forward rate of Indian rupee 64.6394. This forward rate can also be taken as the expected spot rate in 3 months. Let's take another example. The spot rate of the Indian rupee against the British pound is 100. The interest rate in the United Kingdom is 8% and in India it is 6%. What is the forward rate premium or discount of the Indian rupee with respect to the British pound if the interest rate parity exists? What is the forward rate for 1 year of the British pound in terms of the Indian rupee? In this case, the forward premium or discount of the British pound with respect to the Indian rupee will be premium is equal to within bracket 1 plus KH divided by 1 plus KF bracket close minus 1, which is equal to within brackets 1 plus 0.06 bracket divided by bracket 1 plus 0.08 bracket closed minus 1, which is equal to minus 0.0185. Thus, the Great Britain pound is at a forward discount of 1.85% with respect to Indian rupee. The 1 month forward rate of the Great Britain pound is FT is equal to S0 multiplied by 1 plus P, and F1 is equal to 100 multiplied by 1 minus 0.0185 within bracket, which is equal to 98.15. Another example. The following are the interest rates and spot rates of exchange. Suppose the spot rate is US dollar to Indian rupee at 62.45 divided by 50. Interest rate in India is 10% to 10.25% per annum. Interest in US is between 7% to 7.25% per annum. If interest parity holds, what are the forward quotes? The solution is forward bid is less than or equal to 62.50 within bracket 1 plus 0.1025 bracket close divided by bracket 1 plus 0.07 bracket close. That is, forward bid is less than or equal to 65.40. Forward asking is greater than 62.45 within bracket 1 plus 0.10 bracket close divided by bracket 1 plus 0.0725 bracket closed. That is, forward asking is greater than or equal to 64.05. The limits for the forward quotes are therefore between 64.05 to 65.40. Interest rate parity takes two different forms. Uncovered interest rate parity refers to the parity condition in which exposure to foreign exchange risk is inhibited, whereas covered interest rate parity refers to the condition a forward contract has been used to cover exchange rate risk. Each form of the parity condition shows a unique relationship with implications for the forecasting of future exchange rate and the future spot exchange rate. Let us summarize. Exchange rates can be classified as fixed and floating according to the degree by which exchange rates are controlled by the government. Exchange rates are important for government and business organizations to facilitate international trade and payments. Exchange rates are influenced and determined by product prices and interest rates. Exchange rates, whether spot and forward, product prices and interest prices have equilibrium relationship, also known as parity relationships. Also, parity relationships are influenced by arbitrage. The exchange rate is the price of one country's currency in terms of another country's currency and is determined by demand and supply forces in the foreign exchange market. A country's currency is in demand when foreigners buy the goods and services exported by that country, or when they want to buy financial commodities denominated in that currency. Demand for a currency in the foreign exchange market increases with the depreciation of that currency. Supply of a currency derives from the demand for imported commodities denominated in foreign currency. Supply for a currency in the foreign exchange market increases with the appreciation of that currency. The graphical representation of the demand schedule and the supply schedule are called the demand curve and the supply curve respectively. The point of intersection of the demand and supply curve gives the equilibrium exchange rate of a currency vis-a-vis another currency. The quantity of the currency supplied equals the quantity demanded at the equilibrium exchange rate. The factors other than the exchange rate that influence the currency supply and demand are inflation, economic growth rate, interest rates, political factors, social factors, etc. The equilibrium exchange rates changes whenever the position of the demand and supply curve change the influence of these factors. The term arbitrage refers to an act of buying currency in one market at lower price and selling it in another market at a higher price. Differences in these exchange rates in two markets provides an opportunity to earn profit without risk. Arbitrage or international arbitrage can be of three types: locational arbitrage, triangular arbitrage, and covered interest arbitrage. Locational arbitrage is the process of buying a currency at the location where it is cheap and immediately selling it at another location where it is priced higher. Locational arbitrage is also known as simple arbitrage. Triangular arbitrage is also known as three-point arbitrage, as there are three currencies involving three markets. Borrowing in one currency and lending in another, or investing in securities denominated in another currency with the currency risk covered or hedged in the forward market is known as covered interest arbitrage. Once market forces cause interest rates and exchange rates to adjust such that covered interest arbitrage is no longer feasible, there is an equilibrium state referred to as interest rate parity. Interest rate parity takes two different forms. Uncovered interest rate parity refers to the parity condition in which exposure to foreign exchange risk is inhibited, whereas covered interest rate parity refers to the condition a forward contract has been used to cover exchange rate risk. Each form of the parity condition shows a unique relationship with implications for the forecasting of future exchange rate and the future spot exchange rate.